Hi everyone, my name is Mukesh and I am part of Identity Advanced Cloud Engineering team in Microsoft. In this video, we will cover what is Windows Autopilot, different profile types, and how to limit admin rights on devices using Windows Autopilot. So let's begin. Let's start with what is Windows Autopilot and the benefits of it. Windows Autopilot is a collection of technologies used to set up and pre-configure new devices and getting them ready for productive use. It is designed to simplify all parts of Windows device life cycle from initial deployment through end of life. Talking about some of the benefits, using cloud-based services, Windows Autopilot can reduce the overall cost for deploying, managing, and retiring devices. Traditionally, IT pros spend a significant amount of time building and customizing Windows images. These images will later be deployed on devices. Windows Autopilot introduces a new simplified approach. Devices don't need to be re-imaged, rather they can be deployed with the OEM image and customized using cloud-based services. From the user's perspective, it only takes a few simple operations to make their device ready to use. The only interaction required from the end user is to set their language and regional settings. Then they can connect to the network and verify their credentials. Everything beyond that is automated. Prerequisite. For successful registration with Windows Autopilot, we need to make sure that the device's unique hardware identity, known as hardware hash, is captured and uploaded to the Autopilot service. Hardware vendors or resellers generate this hardware hash and upload the details to the Autopilot service. However, for existing devices, these hardware hashes needs to be generated manually by the IT admin. The PowerShell script shown on the screen can be used to generate hardware hashes. This script is also available in our public documentation. Now let's understand what is Windows Autopilot deployment profile. A deployment profile is a collection of settings that determine the behavior of the device during out-of-box experience. We can create up to 350 profiles per tenant. For example, we can create separate profiles for IT admins and developers for them to have different permissions. Now let's go through a demo. Here I am in Microsoft Intune Admin Center. I have selected the Devices tab. Under Platform, choose Windows and then Windows Enrollment. Here under Windows Autopilot Deployment Program, choose Deployment Profiles. Click on Create Profile and select Windows PC here. Here we will give it a name and description that will help us identify the purpose of this deployment profile. On this screen, we can configure the out-of-box experience for Autopilot devices. There are various settings here. We will focus on user account type and leave the remaining settings to their default for this demo. Please look at the tooltip at each setting to understand more about it. Under user account type, we can choose either administrator or standard user. Please note that standard users are not allowed to perform admin tasks on their device, which is suitable for most organizations. By choosing administrator here, we allow the user joining the device to be a local administrator of the device. We do this by adding the user to the Azure AD local admin group. We do not enable the user as the default administrator on the device. Once you are done, click Next. Here you can select the devices or groups that this deployment profile will target. After making the selection here, click Next and the deployment profile is created. I hope this video will help you better understand how to limit admin rights to your devices using Windows Autopilot. Thanks for watching.